and he never say are are vrushala etc., showing disregard towards Chandragupta. It is almost irrational and illogical and not all convincing that the intelligent and towering personality like Chanakya addresses the emperor in a such a reproachful manner. It is a point of quest or research to reconsider the meaning of the term Vrushala in the light of Vrushabha or Vusimaya in Prakrut. Conflict between Chanakya and Chandragupta. I think I will omit this. Use of Prakruts in Mudra Rakshas. Prakrut languages are profusely used in Mudra Rakshas, and it is very amusing that Chanakya Chandragupta narratives are available in Jain Prakrut literature, as I have said, from 4th century AD up to 15th century AD. The Prakruts used in Mudra Rakshas are mainly Magadhi, Shauraseni, and Maharashtri. Other sub dialects are also employed occasionally. 16 characters of the Mudra Rakshas speak in Prakrut. The snake charmer Ahitundika specifically mentions that he is a Prakrut poet. Amatya Rakshas mentions the verse of the snake charmer as a Gartha. The relation of Prakrut and Jainism is very close. The word Gatha we find right from the second Anga Grantha, Sutra Krutanga Dardhamagdi text. The Jainas have created a huge literature in all types of Prakrut, especially Chanakya narratives are found mostly in Prakrut. Main theme of Mudra Rakshas. At the very outset, it could be noted that main plot and the happenings in Mudra Rakshas are absent in the Jain literature. The imaginary name Rakshasa does not occur in the Jain references. But we can find the reason behind the name Rakshasa with the help of the Jain stories. Otherwise, there are no references in Brahmanic literature why the term Rakshasa is used in Mudra Rakshas. The Jainas say that Subandhu, a minister of Nanda's, was waiting for a long time to retaliate upon Chanakya, which is quite natural. And ultimately, he succeeded in setting fire to Chanakya. Due to this brutal act, one can call him Rakshas, having a demonic mentality. There are two versions of Subandhu episode in the Jain literature. Some narratives connect Subandhu with Bindusara, the next king after Chandragupta Maurya, while others, especially the Digambaras, say that the minister of the Nanda, Subandhu, fled away from Pataliputra and became a minister of a king in the southern country. When Chanakya became a Jain monk, according to the Digambar version, and wandered towards south with his Sangha, Subandhu recognized him and put him to death. The main plot of Mudra Rakshas consists of various means and ways undertaken by Chanakya to persuade Rakshasa by hook or crook for being a minister of Chandragupta. All these conspiracies are not noted in the Jain references. The Jainas might have thought that it is impossible to imagine Subandhu to work for Chandragupta because he was totally loyal to the Nandas. Considering the revengeful mindset of Subandhu, there is a logical possibility that Subandhu may retaliate Chanakya and especially Chandragupta after being a chief minister of Mauryan king. I will show you some. In nutshell, we can say that though Mudra Rakshas is a successful political play, its uniqueness left no impact on the later Jain narratives. From this, we can conclude that the legendary material available for the Jainas about Chanakya was different than that of the Brahmanic literature and its antiquity starts before the Christian era. Particularly, the death of Chanakya, which is depicted in Bhagavati Aradhana as the Padapopagamana, means Santhara, is highlighted by Bhagavati Aradhana and also by Shvetambaras. Some minor similarities. The first one is Pataliputra. Pataliputra bears an important position in the ancient history of Magadha and is closely connected with the history of Nandas and Mauryas. Naturally, we find often references of Pataliputra in Mudra Rakshas and by three names in the Jain literature also. Pataliputra possesses a certain important position in the ancient history of Jainas because the first conference of the Ardhamagdhi canon was held at Pataliputra in the regime of Chandragupta Maurya and Chanakya. It is noteworthy that the first Jain Sanskrit philosophical text, Tattvartha Sutra of Umaswati, was written in Kusumapura, probably Pataliputra. Chanakya's Parnakuti, I will omit that portion. I will discuss Parvataka and Vishakanya, the episodes in Chanakya's life. References of Parvataka. It is my thinking that in the history we find the name Seleucus as the appointed minister of Alexander. But the Seleucus, we can connect it with Sanskrit and Prakrit. It may be Shaila plus Okas, having the home in the village, in the mountains. And it is Shaila and Okas. It is Shaila Okas. It is mentioned there as Seleucus. And that is why in Mudra Rakshas and in all Jain narratives, it is mentioned as the name is Parvataka. Reference of Parvataka and his death caused by Chanakya by employing the Vishakanya episode. These incidents are common in both Mudra Rakshas and they are mentioned in Avashyak Churni in almost the same manner. The episode of Malai Ketu is totally absent in the Jain references. Chanakya's power of observation, it is mentioned in the drama like Pipilika Panktim Avalokya. Chanakya suspected the danger to Chandragupta's life by minutely observing a line of ants, Pipilika Panktim Avalokya, coming from the hollow places of the broad walls of Chandragupta's palace. In the Avashyak Churni, it is told that a person called Naladama was killing ants by deeply digging the ground because the ants had done harm to Naladama. Curiously enough, I will quote two lines from Avashyak Churni. Tidandi means Chanakya, having the Tridanda in hand. Tidandi Bahiriyae Naladamam Muingamaragam Dattum, killing the ants. Muingamaragam dattu magato ranna saddhavito dinnamarakam visatthakaya vattadane sa kutumba marya. Chanakya, a kingmaker or a shadow king. It is the modern term, we can relate it. The reference is Bimbantarita Raja. In modern time, the remote control, controlling the kingdom with a remote control, we may remind Manmohan Singh. When we think the relation between Chanakya and Chandragupta with the help of Mudra Rakshas, it is quite clear that Chanakya is really a dominating minister. Chandragupta expresses his inability to transgress Chanakya's words. Not only the third act dedicated to the pseudo-conflict, Krutaka Kalaha, but at the other places also, the supremacy of Chanakya is quite evident. The strict orders of Chanakya are mentioned in Mudra Rakshas 6th act, and in the 7th act, which is the climax of the drama. The dramatist gives a specific art direction to the character of Chandragupta. It is noted down, Raja Chanakya Mukham Avalokayati. That is, the king looks for the decision at the face of to the face of Chanakya. The truth of Chanakya's supremacy is openly told in the Avashyak Churni. The astrologer says to Chanakya's father that he will be a shadow king. Bimbantarita Raja, when he was a little infant, he was an infant. Many a times, Chanakya stops Chandragupta by merely raising the eyebrows. Chanakya openly says in front of a group of the merchants that the king is under my thumb. Raya me vasavatti. The preceptor-disciple relationship between Chanakya and Chandragupta is also noted in Avashyak Churni. Hemachandra uses the word Mauryacharya at the end of the biography of Chanakya. The highest exaggeration is seen in Harishena's Brihat Kathakosh. It is told that actually Chanakya became a king and ruled the country for many years. And after ruling the country for so many years, then he consecrated Chandragupta Maurya on the throne, which is really an exaggeration, I think so. I will give some critical comments. If we try to know biography of Chanakya from the Brahmanic sources, that is the Puranas, Brihat Kathamanjali and Kathakatsarit Sagar, provide very scanty information about the actual life histories of Chanakya and Chandragupta. Many scholars have tried to understand Chanakya with the help of his monumental treatise Kautilya Arthashastra. Some other scholars prefer to study Mudra Rakshas of Vishakhadatta for the better understanding of Chanakya. Though the Mudra Rakshas is a political play, it is full of poetic values, rich with imaginative power, but we think that before writing such a play, the author Vishakhadatta might have gone through the written and oral material available to him at that time. If we assume the date of Vishakhadatta as 7th-8th century AD, we know that the stray references in Digambar literature and the Shvetambar references in Avashyak and Nishita Churni were available to the author. At least, ample oral Prakrut narratives of the Jainas were prevalent in the society. Though these Prakrut legends, he might have come to know the last phase of Chanakya's life, particularly his sad death. Vishakhadatta had chosen a particular part of Chanakya's life in his drama. But if we supply the data before the author with the Jain narratives, we can immediately come to know why he had chosen the name Rakshasa for Amatya Subandhu. The names of Jiva Siddhi Kshapanaka and Sarvartha Siddhi are definitely connected with the Jain environment. The Jain concept of Chanakya's being a Bimbantarita Raja is reflected in the third act of the drama, which is Krutaka Kalava. So conclusive remarks will lie. We have to admit that the Mudra Rakshas, observed from the Jain viewpoint, reveals many new things which are not studied before. It is noteworthy that with a single exception of Jugai Jininda Chariya, one book written by Vardhamana Suri, Mudra Rakshas had left no impact on the Jain literature up till 15th century. It is very interesting to note that in the Colophon, merely interesting, don't get it so serious. It is very interesting to know that the Colophon of the Nishit Churni, it is told that this Churni is written by Vishakhagani. It is very curious to know that the Nishitha Churni is full of Chanakya narratives and appreciates the strict rules of Chanakya particularly. In the other coincidence is also noteworthy. The Digambar sources tells us that Chandragupta was renamed after his initiation as Vishakhacharya. In the Jain narratives and Mudra Rakshas, extreme regard for Chanakya's political wisdom is seen. Both the sources honor Chanakya for his selfless attitude in spite of his shrewd methods. The Mudra Rakshas highlights a particular portion in the political life of Chanakya and Chandragupta in such a manner that it acquired a unique position in the galaxy of classical Sanskrit dramas. The Jainas are interested in giving the whole biography of Chanakya full of various dramatic incidents, but they never tried to write a drama on Chanakya, I think, which is of course a difficult form of literature. If a curious reader wishes to know more about Chanakya, he can knew it by going through the Jain sources, particularly the tragic end of Chanakya and also Subandhu depicted in the Jain literature satisfies the readers by leading them to the logical end of the story. It is the particular tendency of the Jainas that they never prefer loose ends, whether in philosophy and even in narratives. Thank you very much.
Thank you. We'll have questions now. Please raise your hands. You have a question?
Thank you much for illuminating.
Sir, one second. The mic
paper.
Is coming. One second.
Yeah. Madam Nalini Joshi, thank you very much for illuminating the paper. One thing, Shaila Okas, what is the meaning of Okas?
Okas means house.
Huh?
Okas means house, residence.
Okas.
It is a particular, the man of Sanskrit can tell us.
Ambarish Okas. Shaila Okas.
Okas means
Seleucus.
Shaila Okas.
Seleucus.
It is like Parvataka.
Yeah.
Okay.
Huh? Okas means house. That is sure.
You know,
yes, Vanavukasana.
Okay.
In Shakuntala.
Mm-hmm.
Parvataka.
Can't
it be through Girika? Greek?
The name.
Greek. They are from Greek.
Yeah.
They are the Greeks.
The name.
So Girika. It has. Girika must have become Parvataka. Giri equated with Parvata.
But
Parvataka.
It is
Girika.
No, they are not phonetically connected. I have explained the phonetic collection between Shaila Okas and Seleucus.
Seleucus.
The name. And Such? It is interpreted why he is Parvataka in Jain references and also in Mudra Rakshas, he is named as Parvataka.
Parvataka. It is not the synonym of Girika.
No. It is my great imagination
Maybe.
To
but,
connect
but,
these Shailokas and
let
Seleucus.
Us think over this possibility.
Yeah.
Girika
like
must have become Girika. Giri is equated with Parvata and Parvataka.
It
can
be.
It this
can
is
be.
Also one of the possibilities. I am telling.
It can
okay.
be.
Okay.
And
you say, you told at the end that it is the tragic end of Chanakya. According to Jain philosophy, it is not a tragic end. It is the spiritual end of Chanakya. In the spiritual progress, these are the obstacles. These are the obstacles.
Yeah,
putting fire on them or throwing arrows on them, all these are obstacles.
I know it.
You know that.
That accepting Santhara is a very good and Shubha and all. But still, the author of Mudra Rakshas has given name Rakshasa to him.
Also, why
because
should not interpret Rakshasa?
Because he put fire to Chanakya.
Okay.
That's all.
But Rakshasa, usually nowhere we find as a cruel person. रक्षा करने वाला राक्षस होता है
दैट सेज विमल सूर्य ऑफ पौंचर्य
हां
आई नो इट बट I am explaining all these things from the viewpoint of a common person.
क्या है? हर समय चंद्रगुप्ता का रक्षा करता है वो अमात्य.
हाँ.
हाँ? इसलिए उनको राक्षस कहते हैं.
कौन कौन रक्षा करता है? राक्षस
अमात्य.
नो नो, अमात्य राक्षस इज द मिनिस्टर ऑफ नंदास एंड नॉट चंद्रगुप्त.
बाद में क्या किया?
नहीं नहीं नहीं, बाद में नहीं करता. वो राक्षस अमात्य इसका अमात्य हो जाता है.
According
to the
Raksha is a group of people. Yaksha, Raksha, Gandharva, Kinnara. Not from Raksha, not from saving and all. That is not the...
Okay.
Thank you.
Any more questions? There at the back.
Yeah.
Venu?
Please ask.
I thought I saw her. No? You changed your mind? Okay, there. There's a question.
Please.
And after that.
Then come to the bathroom. One minute. टाइम निकल जाएगा, थोड़ा रखिए.
यू मेंशन्ड दैट एम्पल इनजस्टिस हैड बीन डन टू डायनासोर्स एंड एक्सप्लेन्स इन सम डिटेल हाउ दीस हैड बीन इग्नोर्ड एंड व्हाट एस्पेक्ट्स हैड बीन मिस्ड. बट
इन द प्रोलॉग्स और प्रीफेसेस बाय द लर्नेड स्कॉलर्स ऑफ मुद्रा राक्षस.
Yeah, I was wondering if you could elaborate on why this injustice has been committed. Has it been intentional to a degree? Has it been?
No. I do not mean it. It is not intentional injustice, but the learned scholars, then like R.D. Karmarkar and many more, when they edited the text of Mudra Rakshas, the Jain studies and the Prakrut studies was at the stage of beginning. They might not have known that there are so many stories about Chanakya and Chandragupta in Prakrut literature. They do not know the sources, I think so. They gathered some sources from Buddhist literature, but they have not known the exact sources of Chanakya at that time. At means in 1920 or 1930 the texts are edited and they have not mentioned. I am not blaming them that they have purposefully done the injustice. That is not my intention. But still there is a scope to draw the Jain connection with the Prakrut literature which is afterwards published and edited. That is my intention.
Thank you.
Madam, can I ask you a question? Very general layperson question. I was very fascinated by what you said about the number of times Prakrit comes in the manuscript and 16 characters and three different dialects. And recently we had Professor Romila Thapar visiting us.
Yeah,
she was talking about how historians have looked at the Sanskrit plays to see every time Prakrit is used to look at how, say, women and different classes can be read. So I was wondering about, and you know, we also did a course, and it was interesting for us to see the women all, of course, speak Prakrit in these Sanskrit plays. So I wondered if you had any thoughts on out these 16 characters, you know, how many of them are women, or whether about role of women in Jainism, does this play tell us something?
One thing, a good question. There is no women character in Mudra Rakshas. The first kind of that. It is a total political, historical and political play. There is no heroine. Her beauty is not described at length.
What
and
about
nothing Vishakanya? Like that. A total political play. And all the characters who speak Prakrut are male characters. And that is important. So, studying the Prakruts in Mudra Rakshas is itself a total, altogether different subjects. Otherwise, it is the tendency of Sanskritists to read Prakrut from the Sanskrit Chaya and interpret it, and they do not give so much weightage to the Prakrut language in dramas. But nowadays, there is a growing tendency to designate the Prakrut dialects used in Sanskrit dramas. So, though there are three types of Prakrut used in Mudra Rakshas, they are all in Shavraseni Magadhi, and they are almost the male characters are speaking in Prakrut and not female characters.
Thank you.
Yes,
yes sir. You were wanting to ask a question.
It was a good presentation, madam. My first observation is, you know, you can see how the Brahminical hegemony is in and through the drama of Mudra Rakshasa, that you know, he is taking over all other types of you know, if you see the social structure, how Chanakya is predominating all others, including the Jainas. He is using Jainas for his own, like, you cannot say immoral, strategic things.
Yeah.
You know, that is one thing, you know, the Brahminical hegemony, that is number one. And therefore, I go to the your observation whether he was a Brahmin or not. You know, the last verse, I think, when he says that he gives the kingdom to the Nanda and then goes and teaches a few students in the forest where his wife was wasting cow dung water in the floor. Upala sakala metat gomayanam, that verse.
Yeah, that's
you know, that and
the whole description of Parnakuti.
Parnakuti.
I omitted that much portion.
Omitted. But what I want to say is that he does not, he is not depicted by Vishakhadatta as anything else other than a Brahmin. If you see that. And Prushala, that is another thing, the Prushala.
Yeah.
You know, when you like somebody, he's his disciple, you can call him in any name, like your husband or wife, or boy, son and daughter, you call him in different names. So nothing wrong in having
but
such a...
But repeatedly he says...
And it is a drama, it is a drama. And
but
so...
How can informally a person, shrewd person like Chanakya,
see,
say you are a lower caste person, you are a lower caste person, it is not... Please, I am thinking...
No, you are...
Interpret...
No, I am just interpreting in another way.
Yeah,
see, nothing wrong in doing that.
Okay.
And you said the loose ends in the philosophy and religion. What does that loose end mean?
Have you understand? If there is a description of anything, they go up to the rational and logical end of each and everything.
That happens everywhere.
If karma, in karma siddhi, no. I think we will discuss
it. Okay, thank you.
I will give you so many examples of loose ends in Hindi philosophy and logical ends in Jain philosophy. I will explain it.
Anybody else? Yes, we have some time.
Thank you. I think, thank you very much for your very good paper. I just have a yes or no answer question. I know Chanakya stories from Brihatkatha Kosha and Sankata Saritsagara, and their main character is also Shakatala Muni.
Yeah.
And is Shakatala Muni anywhere there in Mudra Rakshasa?
What part I have omitted, the people are asking questions. Yes. In Brihatkatha Saritsagar and Katha Manjari, and in also in Puranas, Chanakya comes there with reference to Shakatala only.
Yes.
And in Harishena's Brihatkatha Kosha, it is also connected with Shakatala.
Absolutely.
But in Shvetambar literature, the Shakatala story is altogether different.
Mm.
And it is, Chanakya is not connected with Shakatala.
Thanks.
So, Shvetambar and Digambar versions are differ in this manner. And also some says that Shakatala himself can be imagined as Amatya Rakshasa.
Okay.
That is also one version of the thinking in the line of that. But in Jain, Shvetambar Jain references, Shakatala is totally omitted in connection with the Chanakya narratives.
Thanks.
So can I leave?
One last question, if anyone wants to. The madam wants to leave yet.
To compensate for the sections that you have omitted, I would like to support you very much on your comment regarding whether it was a decision.